Great to see you. And we have a special Sunday today. We have several people who are out, so thankfully we have a pretty deep bench. And I'm so grateful for Judy, who's going to come and give us our opening prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, we ask that each and every one of us that are here this morning to have that special touch that only you can give us. We ask you to prepare our hearts for the fabulous sermon that Vince and you have prepared. We ask you to just bless this day, make it special. For those that aren't with us here, Lord, touch the needs that they have, bless their hearts, keep them safe. And Lord, we ask you that with the crazy things that are going on in the world, that we remember you are in control and that we need to trust wholly in you, and you will get us through. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
So we're going to have an exciting week this week. Within the next couple of weeks, it's going to be a lot of excitement. It's all about kids. Tonight, we have VBS registration. All are invited. It's from 4 to 6 p.m. Free food, music, games. Come on out. If you have kids, or if you have grandkids or any kids that you know, just drag them out here. Get them registered for VBS because it's going to be a great time. And VBS is going to start Monday the 8th and go through the 12th, and it's going to be from 6 to 8 p.m. The VBS theme is food truck party, so it's going to be great. Remember that the food drive for VBS, we need biscuit mix, pasta, canned veggies, spaghetti sauce, and we have a list on the screen. So, big week next week, La Pastora, she's going to be back. And she's going to have a new sermon series for us. It's called Let Us Pray, and it's going to be based on the Lord's Prayer. We have access to the church bulletin. In the pews, you have little cards with QR codes. You can just go to those codes and get our bulletin. And I think that's it.
So our worship time is going to be a little bit different today, so I need you guys to roll with us. We're going to have some karaoke, so it's going to should be fun. You'll notice that we're missing a few gentlemen here. They have a much deserved day off today for various reasons, so they've left the girls minding the store. So let's do them proud and worship the Lord together. So Dave is our musician today.
Pay special attention to the screens, because some of the arrangements are a little bit different than what we're used to doing. So just watch the screens, watch the bouncing balls if they have it. You all know how to do karaoke, right? You can stand if you want to stand, sing if you want to sing, just have fun. And worship the Lord, main thing.
We're ready.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never failed me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. When my life lay down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running. All my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Let the king of my heart be the fountain where I run, the fountain I drink from. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life. Oh, he is my song. You are good. Good. Oh, you are good. Good. Oh, good. You're good. Oh, you are good. Good. Oh, Lord. Let the king of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the the waves, oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days, oh, he is my song. You are king of my heart, be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves, oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days, oh, he is my song. You are good, you're good, oh. Never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You are good, you're good. Oh Lord, you are good, good. Oh Lord, you are good, you're good. Never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You are good, good. Oh, you are good, good. Oh.
Party time.
Party time.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall. Jesus conquered the grave. Shining light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shining light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King.
Introduce Vince Klemovich, who's going to give us the message today. Oops.
It's okay.
Give me a chance to get ready.
Okay. Oh, wait.
Is that the same one I said?
Yep, it is. Acts 3, 1 through 10. At the gate of the temple, King James Version. Now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man, lame from his mother's womb, was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms for them that entered into the temple. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. And Peter, fastened his eyes upon him with John, said, "Look on us." And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter said, "Silver and gold I have none, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. And they knew that it was he which sat for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. Praise be to God.
Praise be to God. Shalom and good morning. I want to start today with a commercial. We have Vacation Bible School coming in a little over a week. You had to put that up there. Young people, if you want to hear about Jesus, and if you want to come and see what he did in the world and what you can do for him, please come to Dobbins Memorial Church, August 8th through the 12th, 6 to 8 p.m., and come hear about Jesus. Before I really start my message, I have a few disclaimers. Mike, if you're listening and you hear me, I'm pulling my dad card. I'm going to embarrass you in front of the entire congregation. Hey, it's what a dad does. And I'm warning Janet, too. She might get a few good laughs out of this. Her favorite saying to me is, "It's not about you." And then my favorite saying to her is, "But it's not about me. Who's it about?" And if I offend anyone with my words, I say I'm sorry, because my words are my words, and it has nothing to do with the church, the pastor, the United Methodist Church, the church in general. So they have not done anything. But now I want to take you back. How many people remember the old television show Time Tunnel? Okay. Ah, perfect shot. I'm going to take you back into my time tunnel to the year 2017. Donald Trump was president at that time. This is July 2017, so I'm going to take you back 5 years. Donald Trump was president. North Korea was rattling its saber at us and threatening things, and Trump was trying to negotiate with them. A gallon of gas costs $3.52. I looked it up. And Hurricane Harvey is one day away from hitting Texas. Tomorrow, 5 years ago, Hurricane Harvey was going to hit Texas. And then followed by Hurricane Irma, and then that disaster Hurricane Marie that devastated Puerto Rico 5 years ago. And on August 24th, in less than a month, on August 24th at 2 a.m. in the morning, my life changed. Half my body turned off. Don't ask me why, it just did. And I got a CT scan to prove it. They CT'd my head, and they found out my head is completely empty. And they were looking for a bleed, something in my head, because it had to be on the right side because my left side was affected. My left side turned off completely. The only thing I could manage, I'm laying in a hospital bed thinking, I got to move something. And the only thing I could move was my thumb and forefinger of my left hand. Nothing else. I was completely, on the left side, dead. Nothing. I wish I had the words to tell you what it felt like, because I don't have them now. I didn't have them 5 years ago. I was wondering, what in the world is happening to me? My body is betraying myself. And here's the thing of a true chef. I'm laying in the hospital bed thinking, okay, this is Thursday. I gotta go cook. I gotta make gravy. I have tenderloin night. And if anybody knows how to cook tenderloin, you know it's something important. So it's tenderloin night. I can't be sitting here in a hospital bed. I gotta get work to do. But I did. I stayed in that hospital bed for several days, and then I got sent to rehab. Kessler in, what is it, Mount Laurel or Medford? Mount Laurel? Marlton. Kessler and Marlton. So I got sent to rehab. I was there. I had my stroke on a Thursday morning. Saturday, I was in Kessler, and I laid in that hospital bed thinking, okay, I got to go to rehab. What in the world am I going to do? I can't do anything. I talked to the boss upstairs, and I said, why? He didn't give me the why. He just said, get up out of that bed. And I'm going, yeah, right. I'm supposed to get up out of this bed. I can't even move. I move my fingers. That's it. How am I going to get up? But he said, get up. And I said, how? And he said, I'm going to show you how. I'm going to send you people, and they're going to show you how to get up out of that bed. And I'm going, okay. I'm going to get up out of this bed. The following Sunday, not the first Sunday I was in Kessler, but the second Sunday, I read the passage that Judy read so beautifully today. And it said, get up and walk. I wish I could tell you how hard that was. God's telling me, get up and walk. And it's like, yeah, right. I can't do that. But I found good people. Well, they found me. Excuse me. They found me. They found me, and they told me how to stand, how to get up out of a bed, how to walk again. When I got out of Kessler, I went to NovaCare in Delran, and they taught me how to walk with a cane. I transferred from a wheelchair to a walker to a cane. And there are some times when I'm in my kitchen, I can walk without the cane. Very few steps, and I don't want to try to show you now because I'll probably fall. And the first rule in Kessler, floor bad. First rule. You get on the floor, you're going to have trouble getting up. And I do. I have fallen several times since I've been home, and it's always been a real hassle getting back up in an upright position. But in Kessler, I did a few things. Of course, I had to do a few things. But one story in Kessler, when I was first there, I had to have all the evaluations, psychologists and everybody, and then I had a speech therapist. And they said, well, you need speech therapy. As you can tell, I don't need speech therapy. So the speech therapist comes into my room and say, hi, I'm your speech therapist. I'm here to evaluate you. I did this. The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plane. She hits the floor laughing. When she composed herself, she says, in the 8 years I've been a speech therapist, no one has said that to me. So I decided, well, I'm your first, and I hope I'm not the last. So I still had to get evaluated, but she wrote in her report, doesn't need speech therapy. And I didn't go to speech therapy. I needed occupational and physical therapy to get me back. When I was getting close to getting home, which was October, so had my stroke in August. I didn't walk into my front door till October the 3rd, 2 days before my birthday. So I had to show them that I could feed myself. So they said, you either have to make scrambled eggs or grilled cheese. In their facility, they have a complete kitchen, everything, to make scrambled eggs and a grilled cheese. Well, me being a chef, there ain't no way I'm making scrambled eggs or grilled cheese. With the help of Janet, she got me all the stuff. I made the entire physical therapy staff and occupational staff lunch, and I made them a shrimp stir fry. It was very good, too. I had my walker. I have a walker. Now, imagine this. Me in front of a stove, on my feet, with a walker right up against the stove, cooking rice and shrimp stir fry. I got it, put it in the containers, put it out on the table, and I cooked lunch for the entire staff. I had one nurse said, I don't like shrimp. I said, try it, you'll like it. She tried it, she liked it. She said, I don't eat shrimp, but I eat this shrimp. I said, well, congratulations, this is your first shrimp. They loved it. So the band still sings a song, Let Me Tell You About My Jesus. Well, let me tell you about my Jesus. I started to live again, slowly, very slowly. Janet can attest to it. My first couple of days were really rocky, but I got through it. And that's almost 5 years ago. Statistically, a person who's had a stroke of my caliber doesn't live past 3. I have every intention of seeing a lot more years. I have this joke about myself. I have to walk across the street, and I hobble as I go home from here. And people come around those corners and straight down Union Avenue. And it's like, well, I guess that's how I'm going to get taken out, because one guy almost did it that one Sunday. I thought he was going to stop. He didn't stop. He went right around me, full speed. But it's like there's a stop sign at the end of the road. How fast can you go? But these people do it. I don't know when God's going to bring me home. I don't know if I'm going to have a second stroke, because usually, statistically, people who've had my kind of stroke have a second one, and that one kills you. I don't know when that's going to happen, or even if it is going to happen. I don't know. Part of me doesn't care, but I know what I have to do. I can dress myself, I get myself going in the morning, and Janet will tell you, I still cook. And Mike will tell you, I still cook. Right, Mike? And it still takes a time to walk. You know, getting from one place, I say it to myself now, I just need a little more time, so I'm slower, but I still get where I have to go. There's a few things I can't do. I can't walk down steps facing forward. I because I'm off balance. My center of balance is off, so I can't manage that. So I go backwards. I can't use my left arm the way I want to. But this hand has become a vice grip. If I put a jar in this hand and open it with my right hand, I have trouble getting the jar out of my hand because I close it so tightly. There's a couple other good things I do, but I have it on good authority. Two doctors have said this to me and my wife. Janet has taken very good care of me. Said she has. But now I want to close this out by reading you something from John Wesley up on the screen. It's a quote from John Wesley. I wanted to find a definition of Christianity or what it is to be a Christian. I found this in a devotional book. Do all good you can, by all means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as you can. If that's not a definition of what we have to do as Christians and as a church. As a church, we have to do all the good we can. We have a lot of plans for this church. Coming in the next couple of months, we're going to have vacation Bible school in less than two weeks. In the fall, God willing, we're going to have Light the Night. And that's where we're going to need a lot of people. Because a lot of people who used to work Light the Night aren't here anymore. So we have to get our act together. And believe me, the community of Delanco knows where this church is. They do know where this church is. By all the means that we can. 5 years ago, would anybody believe we have a video camera in church and anybody can watch this sermon at any time? 5 years ago, we didn't think of that. There was no such thing as COVID or monkeypox or whatever the problems are of today. In all ways you can, we do it in video. Pastor will be back next week. I'm sure she's got a couple of good ideas. In all the ways you can, there are many ways. I'm doing it right now. And we had Sam and Steve and myself doing this to sub for the pastor. Any one of you could do this, because every one of you has a story. I just told you a little bit of my story. But every one of you has a story to tell. Any one of you can do this. At all the times you can. As long as God has me on this earth, I'm going to be trying to do things. Sometimes they will be behind the scenes, and sometimes they'll be out front. I'm cooking for Vacation Bible School, but I'm also going to be working. And if you come to communion, you've tasted my bread. And I'm going to experiment on you for a couple of weeks. I want to try something new. You might be getting a little tired of challah bread. To all the people you can. I thought of this the other day. To all the people you can, we can't fix a lot of problems in the world because they are way beyond us. But we can fix the little ones here, starting in Delanco, in New Jersey, in the United States. We have missionaries all over the world, and I know two of them personally. I've been to Poland twice, working for John and Dasha, and they were here a couple months ago. We can touch people. Few months we'll be doing Operation Christmas Child. Little commercial here. If you wanted to get school supplies for your Operation Christmas Child boxes, now's the time to get them because they're all on sale. Try Walmart, Target, and all the other places. They're on sale now. Not in November, but you can get them now. You can't solve the world's problems. Believe me, we've tried. And if only everybody would listen to Janet and me, we could solve a lot of problems, but they won't. So we don't worry about that. For as long as you can. I don't know how long I could walk across the street today and some fool comes around the corner and hits me. I may have my stroke. Who knows? But all I know is, when as long as I'm alive, I'm going to be doing something. I want to leave you with this thought. Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can, at all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as you can. My last thought is to you, God be with you until we meet again. Thank you, ladies.
So we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, right? Right? Vince is a walking miracle. He's a walking miracle, and he's... Mike, yes, Mike is definitely a miracle. He's a walking testimony to the power of God's love for us when we're at our weakest, our darkest moments, when we're powerless, we can't do anything. God is there. God is our backbone. God is our rock, and he's there to lift us up. And there's nothing like it. Yep.
Oh,
I'll receive the benediction. God of the universe, God of power, and God of love, show us your love, show us your compassion, and help us on our way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Before this last song, Steve, if you're listening, I just want to say when the cat's away, the mice will play. We're ready.
We're ready.
Count the times I've called your name some broken night, and you showed up and patched me up like you do every time.
I get amnesia, I forget that you keep coming around.
Yeah, ain't no way you'll ever let me down.
Good God Almighty, I hope you'll find me praising your name.
Forever, that your mercy never stops. So why would I assume you'll be somebody that you're not?
Like sun in the morning, I know you're gonna be there every day.
So what on earth could make me be afraid?
Good God Almighty, I hope you'll find me praising your name.
Is he good?
He's good.
Tell me, is he God?
He's God.
He is.
Jesus in the morning, Jesus when the sun goes down.
Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime.
Jesus when the sun goes down.
Woo!